So I just wanna do documents because there's something wrong happening here around the corner in this condo here in the Tres Terraces condo, Lagro, Fairview, Manila, Philippines, Quezon City, and I don't have any connection right now. And as you can see, what happening in my background because I'm I cannot focus right now. So this is what happened. There are lots of mess right now. So that's what happened. And also there's happening here. I did not fix everything now. So why I said that this is happening in all over the all over the Philippines from Luzon, Visayas, Mindanao, and international, because there's something wrong happening when the slummer dirty places squatter in Mindanao that I grow up. I always know what happening. The kids around the corner, they always hurting those kids. And how do you expect a VIP treatment for those people in the slummer area or in the refugee or in the squatter area? There's no any education that you these people doesn't think about the education. And also these people is also in the jail. They're also in the local jail in Mindanao. And that's why the personnel who in charge that they want to get those check card to post them, all these kids to gang stalking. So ayun. And also the politician and also non-politician is involved in this kind of situation. Involved sila dito kasi nga, kumbaga, inuutusan sila to traumatize the new generation or ang mga pag-asa ng ng pag-asa ng bayan or the next politician in the future for a century that they attack with the traumatized hazing, tortures, and all of those happening. And if you ask me if those torture already done to me in the Mindanao, yes, I also go in the other kind of kids, in the cool kids, in the runaway kids, in the prosti kids. I always go with them. Lagi ako yan. Wala akong pinipili. Kaya hindi ako pwede magdala ng money or jewelry na important. Kasi I'm a backpackers kids. And I don't want anything or like phone or jewelry or money that in my pocket. Because the police around the area always check all those things or backpack or things that we have in our backpack. So ayun, kaya medyo mahirap akong pagdating sa ganyan. So kung mapabagsak ako ng mga anak ko for those kind of cool kids, no, until now I'm a cool old ladies right now. And ayun, kung inaakala nyo na mapabagsak nyo ko, hindi ako matotraumatize. And nakakainis lang talaga because I don't have voice and I don't have power to push through, to fight for all those kind of people that mix here in the Philippines from Luzon, Visayas, Mindanao, and international. And this is the sad part. That's why I said to my husband that I want to go back to Hong Kong and push myself to what's the environment in Hong Kong, and I want to learn the Mandarin and I want to learn the Chinese culture that I forgot before what happened to me when I was a kid, because there is something happening that helicopter, because there are lots of people in Zamboanga, Basilan captured also a Chinese kids, and I'm one of those kids that already survived. But the problem is when the time that because my grandmother, my lola, a story about it when she said that I'm ill right now and I'm not feeling well. So you spread the awareness that no matter what happened, there's no safe or secure to all people, targeted people, individuals from Luzon, Visayas, Mindanao, and international. And she said that I reveal what's happening to you. You are not here. You are Chinese, and you are from Hong Kong, and not here. And we teach you to the dialect here in Mindanao because we say goodbye and rest peace, and we cannot walk, we cannot talk now, and just to reveal those kind of emotion until we alive and not take our breath in the laying down of our illness. That's my grandmother said about it, and I said, I know it, I feel it, that I'm not one of these kids. And also I did not forget my childhood, and there's happening that we go in Zamboanga, Basilan, and then there's a helicopter that capture all those Chinese from Hong Kong. And also they are a black belter, they are karate kids, and also some of those kids is already artists from Hong Kong, in Kowloon. They are already artist, model, and they are handsome, they are beautiful. And we are not a bastard. We have our own family. And that's what happened, because my Lola said, did you remember it? And I said, okay, remember it, because when I'm die and when I say goodbye, you should go back to Hong Kong. That's my Lola said. And I said, remember it, because she cannot breathe those time. And I said, can I bring you to the hospital? And my Lola said, only the nature that I love, that rest in peace in me. And if I die or what happened to me, please go back to your root or your Chinese culture, and don't come back to Mindanao. And that's what happened. And I don't know, I forgot the name, but I still remember those times. So what happened in Zamboanga, Basilan, there was a helicopter for limited kids down in Basilan those time, in island in Zamboanga. That time they picked the radio, and they this kidnapper asked for the name of those Chinese. And they said that the last one, the small one, because I'm the small one, and they are all black belter, and also into Kung Fu Fanda like that. And I said, the small girl is go back to Mindanao in Cotabato City, and not in a part of Hong Kong now, because the family of that kids is already tortured in Hong Kong those time. And that's the radio, we hear those radio, and because we have a self-defense, there's a kids that fight with a Kung Fu Fanda, with a black belter, and I'm the one of that. And the sad part is, this kidnapper is a black belter also. He's a master. So he's a Japanese master, and we are only a small black belter, Shanghai, Hong Kong, not master. Because there's a master one, master two, master. And this is the master of all master. It's the same in tennis. There's a tennis one, tennis A, tennis A, B, tennis B, two, tennis B1, tennis B2, and then my husband is a tennis A1. It means he's the master of all master. That's why there's an insecurity going on when you go in the athletes. So that's happening. Maybe we push through. That's why when the helicopter, because when my memories are happening, there's a kids from Hong Kong that already about navigator. And while we are in the helicopter from Basilan to the island of Mindoro, there's some of the kids already in the helicopter. And because they are black belter, because there's no window or door in like that, and they push their, they kick those military, and there's a coming like that, and there's a navigator like that, and those time I don't know what's the dialect of the Philippines those time. And my lola said, you should remember those time because when I die, you go out in these Philippines. And there's a kicking happening because I'm a master of kicking down to the hands because of mixed martial arts. And then there's someone hold those because there's a... I forgot that there's kids from other with a ponytail of like that. The Kung Fu Panda and from Chinese Tibet that already in the helicopter, and there's a happening those time, and all of these kids is taller than me, so I'm the small, and they're all boys and I'm a girl, and they already black belter also, and there's a small one who touched the navigator, and someone kicked the military because they said that when they come back in Manila, rest in peace in Chinese hospital those time. And I said, oh my God, I don't want to be dying in the hospital. So there's a kicking happening, and there's a navigator, and someone kids already hold their arms with those because it said it's not a military. And I said, someone hold those gun and kick like that. And also someone is kick them like that. And then that's happening in Chinese. So you cannot do something to Chinese. They're not talking, they're silent. But that silent is the sign of dying situation. That's what happened. And then when we go in Mindoro, there's a navigator. And then the helicopter is from the ocean. So because some of the kids in Chinese already learned the swimming like that. How can you swim in those ocean? It so takes so deep for the teenager to deep and swim and go in the other island. So I remember that we go in Mindoro, and there's someone already personnel call, and he said, bring them to Cotabato City, and we are not bringing Cotabato City. I remember in the Sierra Madre in Baguio, and there are lots of people here, and there are also lots of kids, and that's what happened. And also we fight when we go another helicopter again because they said this kid is the number one black belter in Hong Kong, and also we don't know how to talk in English because of Chinese Tibet issue, Mandarin those time, and there are lots of fight happening those time. And because I'm a master of kicking down to holding the hands, that's why someone kicked those kidnappers. And it's so sad, lots of people, when they get the radio, it's like a challenge. When they get those kidnappers the radio, there's some of the kids already headshot in the area that they not come to the helicopter. So that's the thing of those time that I remember. And the kids, when the radio said they fight and they kill those men, and he said headshot the other kids in the area in Sambuanga those time. And before we know the radio like that, and there is a helicopter already, we kick the people, it's not a Marines, just a uniform, and we kick it, and now because the navigator those time, we go in the Baguio again, and now we go down in the Lumad, in the Layog also, and there are lots of a challenge. Ang dami naming napuntahan nung time na yon, and hindi kami makapagsalita kasi sobrang puti namin compare doon sa mga taga Baguio. Yung pa yun, yung parang sabi nila, mga artista ba to? Ito ba yung taga
Manila, ganyan-ganyan. And kasi ang puputi na mga Chinese, di ba? So kahit naguhudi kami ng ganyan, kahit nakahudi kami, nakikita pa rin nila. And parang na-amaze sila. Kaya doon dumami ang mga Chinese talaga sa Baguio. Kasi sabi nila, hindi pwedeng hindi sila paramihin. And yun nga lang, nung time na yun, medyo palaban ako. Kaya pagdating ng Baguio, finlight naman ako ng Cotabato na naman ng Mindanao. So doon ako tumagal at napunta ako sa refugee. So ayun, kung kamag-anak ko sila sa refugee, hindi. Ang ginagawa ko noon, lagi ako tumatakas hanggang sa checkpoint and pababalikin naman ako ng mga tao doon. And hanggang na ano na ako sa lugar na yun, hanggang hindi na ako maputi and then parang nagmorena na ako. Ang problema, pagdating ko na naman sa city, pag pumapasok ako, hinahabol pa rin ako ng mga taong yun. So pag tungtong ng alas tres, dapat nasa bahay na ako. Hindi nila kaya tumawi doon sa ilog. Pero sinabi ng mga tao doon nung pumunta ako, kaya na nilang tawirin yung doon sa safety na yung kasi nagkaroon ng floods. Binisita nila yon and tumakbo yung mga tao. So kayo na humusga. Yung ibang lugar na napuntaan ko sa Mindanao ay na-flash out na and already na-abandon na. So yun! Yun ang ano kasi nung time na yon na parang naghaharutan kami nung isang taga doon din sa Cotabato na yon, parang natadyakan ko siya and nakita sa bilyara na hindi normal yung pagtadyak ko sa kanya and sinabi ko, sorry, wag mo akong gulatin kasi ginulat niya ako and napatawa ako and then nagulat siya. Sabi niya, wow, paano mo ako natadyakan ng ganong kalayo as in nagkaganon siya. So ayun, ganon ang tadyakan nung inuhold up ako sa may Pampanga, sa may Nueva Ecija. Gasgas at gumulong talaga mga pangyayari nung time na yon. So ayoko na magkwento. Yun na yun. Kung saan man, thank you at tinuruan nyo ako ng self-defense. Hanggang ngayon, nagsi-self-defense pa rin ako. Hanggang ngayon, magsi-senior citizen na ako. Nagsi-self-defense pa ako. Kaya tuwing madidinig ko ang Sambuanga Basilan, medyo gusto kong lumabas ng school and tumakbo pabalik sa bahay. Kasi yan yung ano. Kaya yung meron yung YouTuber na sabi ko, pwede ko pang puntahan ang Sambuanga Basilan para maalis yung galit ko na namumuo nung time na yun. And also, bumalik yung iba kong memory. And sabi niya, ma'am, hindi po pinupuntahan yung island, hindi po pwede yung kasi sinabi ng Sambuanga City na not allowed to go in Basilan, ganyan-ganyan. Sabi ko, gusto kong puntahan. Sabi niya, hindi lahat tumatawid doon sa lugar. So, ayun, tingnan natin kung saan tayo makarating. Wala pa rin akong signal. So, ayun, there's no safe place to all targeted individual out there. Take care always, everyone. Bumalik yung memory ko nung time na nagkasalpukan kami ng asawa ko and nabagok yung ulo ko and parang nagrembo-rembo and parang gumanon ako and sabi ko, aray ko, aray, ang sakit ng ulo ko. Aray, ang dami kong naaalala. Sandali, gumanon ako. Sabi ko, sandali. Tapos tinula ko siya. Sabi ko, uwiin ako ng Pilipinas, please. Tapos tinatanong niya ako, ano yung sa memory ko? Sabi ko, please get out, please. Maghiwalay na tayo. Sabi ko, may mga memory ako na hindi ko pwedeng sabihin. And nung pumunta kami ng Hong Kong, sabi ko, I really miss this place, Hong Kong. So, ayun! Kung alam ni Hiro, ni Gabi, ang about sa Chinese issue, kaya take care everyone to all the Chinese out there. Nihay. Kasi nga, mahirap ang kalaban talaga kasi master of all masters. So, mag-pray tayong lahat because Buddha is not a god or a lord. Buddha is for awareness because Buddha is one of the targeted individuals na naging gabuna, naging half human and half ghost. Yun lang siya, nakaupo lang siya, just to remind all the people that if you're not listening, if you do some sinner in your life, this is what happened to you. You become fat and sick and you cannot walk anymore. But the kindness of all of that, the people see how your kindness that you spread to all people all over the world. So, ayun! There's no safe place to all targeted individual out there. Take care always, everyone!